This is the new James Monroe bus being inaugurated today. A 16-seater. As you can see, beautiful display. This is the first time we're using it here at James Monroe Senior Center. This is the inaugural ride. Here's Raven Owl Whitehead. How are you, Raven Owl? And there are the first passengers of our maiden voyage. Un momentito, mami. Wave.
Hi. Hey. Happy landing.
The first initial group that's traveling.
There you go.
Buenas tardes y bienvenidos. Seguro Social es muy importante para todos, a mí, para todos ustedes, para poder vivir en dignidad y sobrevivir. No puede importar el Seguro Social, no debemos permitir eso. Y que cumpla, no son de 17, que cumpla mucho más.
What a show, George.
Look at your team.
that the New York State Alliance for Retired Americans does. Thank you all for the great work you do. And it's a true privilege and honor to be on this program with Jesus Laviera. That was just a truly inspiring message that he delivered to us. Yes, let's give him another round of applause. Seventy-seven years ago, on August 14th, my grandfather, President Franklin Delano Roosevelt, said these words: "We can never ensure 100% of the population against 100% of the hazards and vicissitudes of life. But we have tried to frame a law which will give some measure of protection to the average citizen and to his family against poverty-ridden old age." That captures what Social Security is fundamentally about. We can't protect everybody from every hardship, but we can try to provide basic security for people in old age, in disability, or when a parent is lost prematurely. My grandfather left many great legacies, but I believe the most central to all of us must be Social Security. His leadership in establishing Social Security has transformed American society while also reflecting its most enduring values. I have to confess to you that today I am worried by the torrent of distortions and deceptions and falsehoods that the detractors of Social Security try to spread. We have now a presidential and vice presidential candidate who want to do away with Social Security on one side of the equation. We have to fight back. We have to support those who will continue Social Security. We have authors who spread falsehoods about Social Security and lead our children and grandchildren to believe it won't be there for them. Now, as was mentioned, I served as Associate Commissioner for Social Security, and I know that Social Security is financially sound, that it will be there not just through my lifetime and your lifetime, but through our children's and grandchildren's lifetimes. But what are the detractors trying to spread? They're trying to spread exactly what my grandfather fought in the New Deal. They're trying to spread fear about the future of Social Security. President Roosevelt said, "Fear is nameless, unreasoning, unjustified terror, which paralyzes needed efforts to convert retreat into advance." And that's what we have to overcome. When people say it's too difficult to maintain Social Security, or Medicare, or Medicaid, we have to tell them they're giving in to unreasoning fear that with the power of ideas, hard work, we can maintain for ourselves and our children and our grandchildren and for our parents and grandparents.
A civil war to make people free. And we had a new deal from President Roosevelt that was wonderful, that included concepts that everyone had the right to a job, to belong to a union. And thank you so much. When I saw where I was on the program that I had to follow Jesus, I really felt out. There's no way you could follow that man. He was absolutely terrific. And my job was to explain why we're here to celebrate. Well, we're here to celebrate our dignity. And we're here to celebrate our economic security. 77 years we had Social Security, and that's what it gives us. And when you look at this room, there couldn't be a more fitting place to honor Social Security. The history of our region is here.
It's really a pleasure to present to you Dennis Tracy. Dennis is the president of New York State Alliance of Retired Veterans. And it's really a pleasure to have him. And I have to say that he spends hours and hours of his time. And it's a job that's also a volunteer as well. And he goes all over the state talking about the benefits and the entitlements and Social Security.
He has performed his works at 100 community
to continue to enjoy the benefits of this program. So we're honored. We're very honored to be hosting this 77th birthday. And I guess I don't have a proclamation. No, okay. And on behalf of the 1.4 million residents of Bronx County, we want to say welcome to you. We want to say thank you. On behalf of Borough President Ruben Diaz Jr., we thank you for all the organizers of today's celebration. Again, welcome to the Bronx Borough Hall and enjoy the rest of the program. Thank you for being here. The Social Security program was designed to help our country's elderly live above the poverty level. It has been. On behalf of Borough President Ruben Diaz, I want to welcome you to our chamber, to our home, and say thank you for coming here, considering the Bronx as the place that you would celebrate the 77th anniversary. I want to share with you that, first of all, let me say welcome to all the esteemed guests who are here this morning. We thank you for being here, and we're very excited about hosting this event. I want to welcome you this morning. I've got to find my place here. I want to welcome you this morning to the People's House. Which is Bronx Borough Hall, as our borough president likes to call it. We call it the People's House because everyone is welcome to come in and be a part of us. I also want to acknowledge and thank Congressman Jose Serrano's representative who's here this morning, Ana Vicente. I want to thank her for being here this morning.
Ms. Green is a graduate of